I'm asking what is your name. Chalo, we'll start today. Okay. Chalo. We'll start. So today we have like how to present yourself in Spanish. So if you're asking, ¿Cómo te llamas? ¿Cómo te llamas? We have a verb llamar. We already wrapped up llamar verb. LLAMAR. Llamar verb. Right? Llamar is basically is to call. Is it clear to you? We have saple verb. So here we have llamar verb. Okay. So we have ¿Cómo te llamas? Speak up. ¿Cómo te llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas?
Speak up. Hola. Speak up. Hola.
Hola.
So if you're meeting first time with the people, you're asking, because today we have like how to present yourself in Spanish. So if you're asking, what is your name? Speak up. ¿Cómo te llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas?
And if you're saying, my name is simple, me llamo. Why llamo? Because we have air ending verb. In air ending verb, what is the formula of I? That is converted into O. So me llamo, your name. Me llamo Khushbu, me llamo Anna, me llamo Napoleon, anything. Okay? Me llamo Kathy, anything like this. So speak up. Hola, ¿cómo te llamas? Speak up.
Hola,
¿cómo te llamas? You say, me llamo, my name is Tess. What? Okay? And you,
E tu,
that's a question mark. Okay? E tu, that's a question mark. Speak up. And you, speak up. Speak up. And you, speak up. Speak up. E tu, now speak up. ¿Cómo te llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas?
Speak up. ¿Cómo te llamas?
¿Cómo te llamas?
Me llamo Ana, me llamo Khushbu, E tu, and you. So what the person will reply?
Me llamo.
Jo bhi aapka, what is your name? Okay. So now you're asking, where are you from? You ask the people, like, where are you from? So what you will say? De donde eres? Speak up. We already have wrapped up de donde.
Yesterday we did.
Yesterday conversation we have done de donde. Speak up. De donde eres? De donde eres is where are you from? Eres is basically we have a said verb. We have said verb na, right? We already have wrapped up said verb. So that's my adverb in French. So eres. Yo soy tu eres. We have wrapped up, right? So de donde eres? Eres is my is MR. Where are you from? To speak up, de donde eres? Speak up, de donde eres?
De donde eres?
For example, you're saying, I am from Colombia. So you will say, I am from, so what you will say, I am. If you're saying, I am from Colombia, for example. So what you will say? Soy, I am soy, yo soy, soy de Colombia. Is it clear to you? Soy de Colombia. For example, saying, I am from India. I am from India. So what you will say? Soy de India. Is it clear to you? Soy de...
Country's name
is simply rehte hain. I will explain to you. A pattern aayega, will explain to you country's name also. Theek hai? Soy de India. कल हम कर लेंगे कंट्रीज एंड सिटीज के नेम ठीक है सिंपल ही है इसमें सो आई एम फ्रॉम इंडिया इफ यू आर सेइंग आई लिव इन फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू आर सेइंग आई लिव इन चंडीगढ़ आई लिव इन चंडीगढ़ सो चंडीगढ़ सेकंड So what you will say, I live in Yo Vivo, because we have a vivir. Okay. Yo Vivo in, it means in Chandigarh. Is that clear to you? if you're saying I am from India, if you're saying I am from India, so what you will say? Yo vivo. Yo, I am from India. Yo vivo de. De is from. De India. Is it clear to you? Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Right. So this is a pattern basically. So speak after me. So bolo aap, please speak up. Hola, como te llamas? Speak up. Hola.
Oh, como te llamas?
Me llamo. Y tú and you. Me llamo. Y tú and you. Okay. Then me llamo, the person name. You're asking like, where are you from? So what do you say? De donde eres?
De donde eres.
Soy de Colombia. Soy de India. I live in Chandigarh. Yo vivo en.
In Chandigarh.
I'm from India. Yo vivo de India. Is it clear to you?
Yo vivo de India. Yes.
Is it clear to you? Okay. For example, you are saying, I am French professor. Because you are presenting yourself like you, both of you are French professors. So you will say, I am a French professor or teacher. Is that clear to you? So what you will say? Soy professora. If you're a female, that is profesora. Speak up. Soy profesora de francés.
De
francés. If you're saying, I am a French teacher, so what you will say, soy profesora de francés. If you are a male, so what you will say, soy profesoro. Professor de Frances. Is that clear to you? So if you're saying, I am a French professor, I am a French teacher, so what you will say? I am soy profesora de Frances. If you're saying, I am an English teacher, so what you will say? I am English teacher. Soy profesora de Inglés. Speak up, de Inglés. Speak up. Soy profesora de Inglés. Is it clear to you? Is it clear to you, senorita, senora? Is it clear to you? Soy profesora de Inglés. Okay. Now you are saying, I am working, for example, you are saying, I am working in French Institute, for example. I am working in French Institute. So you tell me, what is the verb of work? You tell me first. What is the verb of work? Tell me. Trabajar, we already have wrapped up trabajar. We have to wrap up these verbs. So what we have to do is, 50 verbs which we already wrapped up, right? You have to do practice for this. I will share the link also, that 50 verbs which we have wrapped up. I have a link. So do you have the link, that 50 verbs which we have wrapped up? Aapas yes. Link hai uska?
Yes, sir.
Link hai aapas uska? 50 essential verbs.
Mm-hmm.
I will send it to you also. So you will go with this question, because that 50 verbs play a vital role. Is it clear to you? To work is trabajar. Okay. So you are saying over here, I am working in French Institute. Okay. So what you will say, estoy is I am. See, it is very simple. I will explain to you ing sentence also. Whenever we have an ing sentence, my trabajar is converted into trabajando. Trabajando. Basically, ando is my ing sentence. Is it clear to you?
It's equivalent to ing form.
Yes. We have English is ing form. In Spanish, we have ando form, ando. Is it clear to you? Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Is it clear to you? So yes, if sir. I'm saying, I am working in French Institute, I am working. So in that case, we'll use a star verb. We will not use said verb. In my ing form, we'll use a star verb. Okay. So what I will say is estoy trabajando, trabajar. So here we have trabajando. Estoy trabajando with, I'm working with French Institute, con el instituto, is my institute, instituto, con el instituto de francés. If you're saying I'm working with French Institute, so what you will say, estoy trabajando. Why trabajando? Because trabajar is my verb to work. So in case of ing form, my ar is converted into ando. That ar is converted into ando. So that is estoy trabajando con, with the Institute of French, con el instituto de francés. If you're saying I'm working,
I have a doubt.
Yes, tell me.
सर तो मतलब जैसे इंग्लिश में होता है आई वर्क एंड आई एम वर्किंग, ये दो डिफरेंट चीजें स्पेनिश में भी हैं.
एग्जैक्टली
एग्जैक्टली. इफ आई से आई एम कुकिंग या कुछ भी, तो सर मैंने ए एंड डी ओ लगानी.
यस दैट इज आंदो, कोकिनांदो हो जाएगा देन वो, बिकॉज़ कोकिनार इज अ वर्ब टू कुक. ओके दैट इज कोकिनांदो, आई एम कुकिंग. इज इट क्लियर टू यू? सो यस, that ando is my ing. If you're saying I'm working in French Institute, so my con is converted into in, because that's a preposition. So here you have two preposition, guys. One is con, con is with, and one is in, in is in. If you're saying I'm working in French Institute, so what you will say, estoy trabajando con el instituto de francés. If you're saying I'm working with French Institute, in French Institute, pardon, so you will say estoy trabajando en el instituto de francés. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Clear?
Yes, yes.
Okay, if you're saying we already have wrapped up age portion, like we already have wrapped up counting portion. If you're saying I am 28 years old, so the same in French. In case of whenever I'm telling the age in French language, I have to use our verb. I cannot use être verb.
Yes,
the same in Spanish also. I cannot use ser verb. Basically, I am a ser verb, but I have to use tener verb.
Have
verb. So what I will say, tengo, I am. That cannot be soy. Tengo 20. 28, we already have wrapped up. 28 is 28. Okay, tengo 28 años. So here we have, no is my, so here we have años. Is that clear to you?
Yes,
sir. So if you're saying, if you're telling your age, okay, I am 28 years old. So what you will say? Tengo
28 años.
If you're saying, I am 27 years old. So what you will say? Tengo 27 años. Is it clear to you? Is it clear to you?
Yes.
If you're saying, I am living with my family, I am staying with my family. For example, you are saying, I am living with my family. So what you will say? Vivo with my family, con mi familia. Is it clear to you? If you're saying, I live with my family, I live with my family. So what you will say? Vivo con mi familia. Is that clear to you? Vivo con mi familia. So can we repeat? Okay. Chalo, let's repeat this thing. Speak up. Hola, ¿cómo te llamas?
Hola, ¿cómo te llamas?
Me llamo.
¿Y tú?
Me llamo.
Kushbu.
¿De dónde eres? Speak up. ¿De dónde eres?
¿De dónde eres?
Soy de Colombia. Okay. Yo vivo en Chandigarh. Speak up.
Yo vivo en Chandigarh.
Okay, then you are saying, I'm a French professor. Soy profesora de francés. Soy profesora de inglés. I'm working in French Institute. Speak up. Estoy trabajando.
Estoy trabajando en el Instituto de Francés.
I'm 28 years old. So what do you say? Tengo 28 años. Is it clear to you? You're saying I live with my family. So what you will say? Vivo con mi familia. Is it clear to you?
Con mi familia.
Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
If you're saying, Khushbu and Neha, I'm learning French, because you are presenting yourself, so you have to stretch your conversation. Sorry, I'm learning Spanish since 4 weeks. For example, since 4 weeks. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
So here again, we have a verb aprender. We have already have grabbed up aprender is to learn basically. So we have estoy. I am learning. Estoy aprendiendo. Aprendiendo. So why here we have endo? Why not ando? Because in case of ear-ending verb, my ing is converted into endo because this is aprender. Aprender is to learn. So we have a verb, aprender is to learn. Is it clear to you, senora?
Yes.
Is it clear to you? So you are saying, I'm learning Spanish since 4 weeks. So what you will say? Estoy aprendiendo, okay? Estoy aprendiendo español, okay? One second. Español. Is it clear to you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what you have is I'm learning Spanish since 4 weeks. Estoy aprendiendo español since desde hace, speak up. Desde hace, cuatro is four. Desde, you can say like this simple, desde, since. Cuatro is four. Okay, then we have semana. Semana is your verb. So if you are saying, I am learning Spanish since 4 weeks. So what you will say? Estoy aprendiendo español desde, that is, cuatro semana. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Okay. If you're saying I'm learning Spanish in 4 weeks, estoy aprendiendo español desde cuatro semanas. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Then you will say, my hobbies are. You will say, loisir in my French. Okay. So if you're saying, my hobbies are. So what you will say? Mis, because this is my plural, hobbies, mis pasa tiempos. Speak up. Pasa. Pasatiempos is your, we have time pass. For example, you can learn like this. Pasatiempos is your hobbies. Son, because that's a plural, ser verb. Ser plural is what? Son. Ellos, ella, son, we do. Ellos, ella, son, if you remember, ser verb is MR verb. So, mis pasatiempos son. You tell me your hobbies. For example, you say, My hobbies are to read newspaper. Read is lire, that is lire. In French, we have lire, right? Here we have lire, periodicos. Periodicos is your journal. Speak up, periodicos. One second. Okay, here we have. Okay, that's O accent. Okay, so here we have periódicos. Periódicos is basically your reading newspaper. If you're saying mis pasatiempos son, my hobbies are leer periódicos. Periódicos is your reading newspaper. You are saying listen music. Escuchar is your listen. That's a verb. Escuchar
yes,
musica. Yes. Escuchar musica. You, we have an accent. Put the accent over here, like O, we have accent, and you, we have accent. Escuchar musica. You will say reading novels. Leer novelas. Is that clear to you? Leer novelas. If you're saying playing indoor games, jugar is to play. Speak up. Jugar is to play. Jugar juegas. Playing indoor games. Games is my juegas. Okay? Juegas. Jugar is to play. Theek hai, are you understand?
Yes, sir.
You understand this? So, jugar. Jugar is to play. Juegas is to game. If I'm saying playing indoor games, like you are a girl, so you maybe you have interest, you are playing indoor games. Jugar juegas de interior. Interior. Is that clear to you? Like you are a girl, you maybe you like dance, so you will say I like dancing. So me gusta. We have a gustar verb we already covered. Gustar, bailar. Bailar is your dance. So you will say I like dancing. Me gusta bailar. Is it clear to you? Is it clear, senora?
Yes, sir.
So if you're saying mis pasatiempos son, my hobbies are leer periódicos, escuchar música, leer novelas, jugar juegas de interior, me gusta bailar. Speak up, please. Tell me your hobbies, please.
Mis pasatiempos.
Speak up, pasatiempos.
Pasatiempos son leer periódicos, escuchar música, leer novelas, jugar the
interior, the interior.
Me gusta velar.
Me gusta velar.
Escuchar is to listen.
Me gusta velar is
velar dance. I like that.
Me gusta where? Bailar. Bailar is to dance. Bailar. Bailar is to dance. Is it clear to you? So speak up. Mis pasatiempos son. Speak up. Mis pasatiempos son. Speak up, please. Mis pasatiempos son. Leer periódicas, escuchar música, leer novelas, jugar juegas de interior. Me gusta bailar. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
If you're saying, I have a brother in my family, kuch bhi. Okay, I have a sister. If I'm saying, I have mother, father, grandmother. So how we can say these things? So brother we called as hermano. Speak up, hermano. Hermano is your brother. Speak up, hermano. Speak up, hermano. Speak up, hermana. Speak up, hermana. Okay, hermana is your sister. You're saying grandmother. Abuela. Speak up, abuela. Abuela is your grandmother. Speak up, abuela.
Abuela.
Abuela is your grandmother. Abuelo is your grandfather. ठीक है, amiga is if you have a girlfriend that is amiga, if you have a boyfriend that is amigo. For feminine we have friend amiga, for masculine friend we have amigo. Okay, madre is mother, padre is father. Is it clear to you? Madre, padre.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
So can you repeat? Yeah. So if I'm asking, ¿cómo te llamas? So what you will say?
¿Cómo te llamas?
Me llamo.
Me llamo.
Me
llamo. ¿Y tú? Me llamo.
Me llamo.
I'm saying, where are you from? De donde eres?
De donde eres?
Colombia. Soy de India. Okay. I live in Chandigarh. Yo vivo en Chandigarh. Okay. I'm from India. Yo vivo de India. Okay. I am French professor. Soy profesora de francés. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
I am an English teacher, so what you will say? Soy profesora de inglés. I'm working in French Institute. Like you are a French professor, so you are working in French Institute. So what you will say? Estoy trabajando con, con el Instituto de Francés. If you are saying in French Institute, estoy trabajando en el Instituto de Francés. Is it clear to you? I am 28 years old, so what do you say? Tengo 28 años. Tengo 27. Okay, 25, whatever your age would be. Okay, I live with my family. Vivo con mi familia. I'm learning French in 4 weeks. Estoy aprendiendo, okay, español desde 4 semanas. Is it clear to you, señora?
Yes.
My hobbies are mis pasatiempos son leer películas, leer novelas, jugar juegos de interior, me gusta bailar. Is it clear to you?
Okay.
Clear, señora?
Yes, sir.
Hermano, hermana, abuela, abuelo, amiga, amigo, madre, padre. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Now, what you have to do is, now you have to make your present yourself. Like if you ask to me, present yourself in Spanish. So what I will say, me llamo, soy de India, soy de Chandigarh, yo vivo con mi familia, okay? Soy de profesora en, English, Francés, Español, okay, Japanese. Is it clear to you? And so you can create like this. If I'm saying I am 30 year old, so what I will say, tengo 30 años. Is that clear to you? I'm learning French since 4 weeks. If I'm saying, okay, estoy aprendiendo. So you can say like this. So can you create your own things in present yourself in Spanish?
Yes, sir.
Can you create?
Yes, sir.
Can you create? So now I'm giving the task. What you have to do is, you have to create your 10-15 lines which we have done, like how to present yourself in Spanish.
Okay.
Is that clear to you? So now you have lot of things, like we have wrapped up two conversations. These are tasks for you, which I'm giving to you. Now you have two conversations which we have wrapped up, and one present yourself in Spanish. You have to be ready yourself by tomorrow. There would be no excuse, because you know what? I want that your level would be come, because tomorrow again we'll go for a next conversation. The conversation would be, you are going to see the to watch the cinema. You are asking your friend, can you come with me to cinema? What are you doing tomorrow? No, I am very busy. I cannot come. No, please take out your 3 hours that we'll spend. We'll do lot of enjoyment we'll have. Then after convincing him, you have to explain yourself, like what you have done in the cinema. Did you enjoy or not? So this conversation we'll do tomorrow. But before going moving pattern to this type of conversation, you have to have two conversation which we have wrapped up. The link I will send it to you. I think you already have the link.
Yes,
that what I would say. You have the link of two conversation, the YouTube link. You have this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, आपको क्या करना है अब?